New at 6, Haitian immigrants forced to leave their country after that devastating earthquake are afraid they are the latest target of the Trump administration.
They are here legally, but their special visas expire soon. NBC2's Dave Elias talked to one young Haitian today. Dave?
Yeah, Peter, back in 2010, 60,000 Haitians came to the United States and they were given temporary relief. Included in the 60,000 was one Haitian family that's living here. And among those, it was a young boy, he and his mother. Well, that boy, now a grown man, faces going back to a country that he doesn't even know unless President Trump steps in to help.
God put us on this earth for a reason.
Kenny Charles was put in Haiti until his mother brought him to the United States when he was 5.
I was obviously a kid, a baby or whatever, and you know, my mom came, she came here, told us that, you know, we needed a better life.
He was eventually granted TPS, or temporary protection status, in 2010 after a devastating earthquake destroyed Haiti.
The person don't feel the struggle another person feels.
He now struggles with being deported back to Haiti unless President Trump signs an executive order to extend TPS.
It's like putting someone in the middle of nowhere, you know, trying to survive.
Survival in Fort Myers is tough, too.
He's supporting his mom, who's going through dialysis 3 times a week.
His immigration attorney, Indira DeMine, says nearly 60,000 Haitians across the country are just like Kenny.
You are now a target for deportation.
It's not like they could round up the Haitians and just put them on a boat or a plane and send them back.
Retired federal immigration judge Anthony Rogers, now a practicing attorney, says that Kenny and others would have due process.
They know who they are. They know their background.
But Kenny fears that still may not be enough to save him and his ailing mother from deportation.
My mom is under my wing now.
He makes this appeal to President Trump.
Try to put yourself in our position.
Now, the TPS program for Haitians expires July 22nd. If President Trump doesn't extend it, 60,000 Haitians living here will also lose their jobs and their driving privileges. They would then be subject to return to Haiti. Live in the studio tonight, Dave Elias, NBC2.
All right.